people and gods, in the days of innocence and the era of myths. Deserted cities and mysterious masks unveil an ancient, unsolved mystery. More than 4,000 years ago, the ancient kingdom of Shu, under the reign of King Wu Fu, reached a period of unprecedented prosperity. Buried for thousands of years, mysterious masks, high altars, and scepters were eventually unearthed for all to see. These delicate and exotic cultural relics provide clues to an amazing culture that existed 4,000 years ago, but they raise many questions. Who did they belong to? And why were they discarded and buried in what was obviously a great hurry? What exactly happened in this kingdom 4 millennia ago? On June 18th, 2014, visitors from all over the world gather in the exhibition halls of the Sanxingdui Museum in Sichuan Province. They are stunned by the cultural relics they see before them. For them, it's like experiencing the distant and mysterious ancient Shu Kingdom itself. Meanwhile, Yu Jian and his colleagues are busy working in an office next to the museum. It may look simple, but the task is, in reality, very complex.
Now we see these 3 Qing Tong monuments have different degrees of preservation, especially this Qing Tong head mask. Because when buried, it was hammered, so the side of its ear has been broken. 那么我们现在呢，准备对这件文物进行一个研究性复原修复。This
is a clip from Jackie Chan's 2012 film Chinese Zodiac.
几乎接近1:1的复制品。能摸一下吗？
我们可以。谢谢。
In the movie, Jackie Chan puts on a pair of scanning gloves. As he touches the bronze animal head, a 3D imaging system begins to compute a model of the bronze artifact. The model is then 3D printed, colored, and heated. Before long, an almost identical replica of the bronze animal head is produced. To restore this cultural relic, Yu Jian and his colleagues are going to use 3D scanning and printing technologies that are very similar to those depicted in the movie.
When the 3D scanning and printing technologies that are very similar to those depicted in the movie.
3D scanner printers first appeared in the United States. Conventional cameras simply record colors in 2 dimensions, but a 3D scanner actually measures an object in 3 dimensions at high speed and with a high level of precision. The resulting data can then be used to create a very accurate 3D model. 3D scanning and printing technology was first applied to large industrial surveying. As the technology has matured, it has gradually been applied to other areas. In Britain, a supermarket provides a 3D scanning service. The customer is scanned using a 3D scanner, and in just 2 minutes, the result is a life-size figure.
Thank you.
Two researchers from Harvard University's Semitic Museum have used a 3D printer to successfully restore a broken 3,000-year-old porcelain object in the shape of a lion. This is the first time Chinese researchers have attempted to restore cultural relics using 3D scanning and printing technology. Yu Jian and his colleagues place the bronze mask on a scanner connected to a computer. As the mask is scanned, the image data collected from the object is transmitted to the computer.
这是我们通过 3D 扫描然后获得的一个三维数据。 然后我们通过3D软件去它进行合成处理，然后最终形成一个接近文物原貌的3D模型。
The two pieces of the mask have now been scanned. By integrating the data obtained through scanning each piece, they'll be able to produce a complete model of the mask. After a full day of effort, a 3D model of the mask has been generated, and now all that you need to do is press a button. The printer will work continuously for more than 20 hours, and tomorrow Yu Jian will know how this experiment has worked out. Today, Yu Jian has come to the office very early with a mixture of expectation and some anxiety. He slowly opens the printer. In front of him, a yellow mask appears. Made of resin, it's an accurate replica of the broken bronze mask. It will be used to help restore the original mask. The old way of restoring artifacts was to make molds of the original cultural relics, but this process could cause further damage to the precious items. Now, with the help of 3D printing technology, researchers can substitute original cultural relics with resin replicas. The researchers are going to use the resin replica to make a plaster mold. After about half an hour, an accurate plaster mold of the original bronze mask will take shape. After being carved and refined a little, the mold will be sent to a casting factory where an identical bronze replica of the original mask will be produced. People and gods, in the days of innocence, in the era of myths. Deserted cities and mysterious masks unveil an ancient, unsolved mystery. Yu Jian has been working at Sanxingdui Museum since 2004. Although he didn't participate in the excavation of the two sacrificial pits in 1986, when he walked into the exhibition hall and saw the beautiful and mysterious objects for the first time, he found he was deeply attracted by them.
我最喜欢的文物就是这一株青铜神树，特别是神树上的青铜鸟造型很有意思，很特别。
At nearly 4 meters tall, this bronze tree is one of the tallest bronze items ever unearthed in China. But the most mysterious part of it are the 9 birds standing on the branches.
Just why this bronze tree has so many birds? Generally, I
think it reflects this. 十日神话，
就说是太阳啊，太阳是被这个鸟托付做的啊。
本来我们说十日神话为什么只有九只鸟呢？因为神话记载所说的，在这个栖息在这个扶桑树上面的十个太阳是吧？是一日方至，一日方出，就说有一个太阳始终是在天空的，所以说九只立鸟它代表的是。九个太阳，但是实际上是十日神话的真实写照。
The river that flows around Sanxingdui is called Duck River, and every summer when the water rises, local fishermen set their boats on the river. These fishermen still use traditional fishing methods.These black and very agile birds are cormorants. At Sanxingdui Museum, there are many bronze birds with long beaks. But why have so many images of birds from the ancient kingdom been found? What was so important about birds?
就是三星堆的祭祀坑里面有很多鸟的形象，这一点是非常有意思的，而且也跟古时的一些传说有关系。还比如说，就是我们伟大的诗人李白写过一首那个《蜀道难》。然后其中有一句就是蚕虫及鱼腐，开国何茫然。
Historical records have it that the first 3 kings of Shu were Sansong, Bai Guan, and Yu Fu. Scholars believe that the bird images found at Sanxingdui are closely related to one of those 3, King Yu Fu.
有人认为这个鱼凫，它可能就是鱼鹰，就是捕鱼的一种水鸟。那么它的形象很像那种篝火啊，很相似。实际上，鱼和鸟就可能是代表了这个鱼凫王的一种图腾。
This is the site of a Yufu clan village in Sichuan province.Local legend has it that the Yufu most probably came from the regions around the Min River. Originally, they lived by and fished in the Min River, but later migrated to the river regions on the Chengdu Plain. There, they settled and built up a prosperous kingdom.
The best, the best.对，就是三星堆这个地方，三星堆这个古城。那么可以这样子讲啊，就是在商这个阶段，三星堆古城应该是最发达、最先进的一个政治、经济、文化中心。
More than 3,000 years ago, the ancient people of Sanxingdui built altars, cast trees and scepters in bronze that represented supreme power and adopted as their clan totem the image of a bird. sacrificial objects buried in such a hurry? And what led to the downfall of this prosperous ancient city? Sanxingdui is located on the northeastern Chengdu Plain on the edge of a highly active seismic belt. In the last few centuries, the Longmen Mountain seismic belt has seen over 10 earthquakes above magnitude 6, as well as numerous smaller quakes. The devastating 2008 Wen Chuan earthquake occurred on the north-central part of this very same seismic belt, and it greatly affected archaeological work at Sanxingdui. Many of the pottery pots, painstakingly restored by the archaeologists, were shattered. Did a major earthquake 3,000 years ago cause the destruction of the ancient city? Archaeologists carrying out excavation work at the Sanxingdui ruins haven't found any disturbance of the different cultural layers caused by earthquakes. This means the ancient city did not suffer from any major earthquakes 3,000 years ago. The possibility that an earthquake led to the city's demise has to be excluded. Sanxingdui is located on an alluvial plain formed by the Duck River to the north and the mighty Ma Mu River that crosses it. When people built cities in ancient times, water was always the first consideration. All four of the world's ancient civilizations rose beside water. But water can, of course, always be a threat. It may even destroy a city. More than 4,000 years ago, a highly developed civilization rose in the Indus Valley. It was known as the Harappan civilization. There are many traces of flooding in the Harappan ruins, and even on a number of the cultural relics unearthed from the ruins. It seems that the disappearance of the Harappan city might well have been caused by flooding. Sanxingdui was built in the same era and in geographical conditions that are quite similar. Could the demise of Sanxingdui have been caused by flooding too?
据林湘老师讲， 1986年在 第三区发掘的时候，有一个探方T14，第七层好像是，他说有红基层，但是即使有的话，我想那个红基层是到底是水塘呢，还是真正的红基层呢？即或是真正的红基层的话，也可能是只有那一次，而不是在整个遗址大范围里面，没有发现很大的红基层。
The surprising diluvial formation might have been caused by a flood in ancient times. But it's not sufficient evidence to prove that the ancient city of Sanxingdui was destroyed by flooding. These kneeling figures, just 20 centimeters tall, depict gestures and facial expressions that are very similar to those of the bronze figures unearthed in
Sanxingdui.
更多的可能就是王权与神权之间的喋喋不休的一种这个争权夺利。然后在三星堆的时候，变法人是王权的所有者，而簪法人是神权的，代表神权、神权阶层的。
This standing figurine from Jin Sha is wearing the same robe and is using the same hand gesture as the bronze standing figure found at Sanxingdui. Clearly, he too is a priest.But instead of a hair pin, his hair is braided.
到了金沙时候，掌握最高权力的时候，变了，那么变成什么？变成变法人，就是那么就也就是说，变法一族战胜了这个簪法或者是非变法一族，于是就迁都到金沙，有这帮人有这个变法一族继续执政。
Perhaps on a tense night, more than 3,000 years ago, the ancient Shu kingdom witnessed an outbreak of civil strife. The fighting that ensued was between people with braids and the people with hairpins. In the fire of war, various valuable sacrificial objects were burnt and then buried. The once flourishing Sanxingdui city was destroyed by civil strife.Where did the city of Sanxingdui come from? Almost a century has passed, but still no one can answer this question with certainty. Today, researchers are exploring the mysteries of Sanxingdui using the latest technology. But despite this, the veil has yet to be lifted. Perhaps, as Chinese writer Yu Chuyu once said, a great civilization should retain a little mystery. Chinese culture is too clear.But fortunately, we still have Sanxingdui.